Everybody, thank you so much for stopping by. This is the Otter Bing Reacts. My name is Millie T, and I hope you've had a wonderful day, night, weekend, or holiday.
It ain't hard to be real, it ain't hard to be real.
I just always do my own thing,
It's just something you could feel. I've been working all day.
Okay, everybody, like, you know the routine. You know the routine of this channel by now. If y'all see me looking some kind of crazy, we working with that Regina George confidence. Y'all know what I'm talking about. When they cut a hole in Regina George's shirt to try and sabotage and embarrass her, how dare they? Regina was just like, it's whatever. And that's what we working with today. Y'all, I'm having a bad hair day. You know what that's like, y'all. So I try to put a hat on it. The hat don't want to act right. Or a beret. This is my beret. I say it like this. Beret. Well, I got my beret on. And y'all, we just going to work with it. It's that Regina George confidence that we're working with today. Okay? So thank you all for joining me. I got a request. I'm so excited. This request is from... Oh... That's hilarious. This is a Leona Lewis Bleeding Love on that video. My reaction for Leona Lewis's Bleeding Love, which was very beautiful. She looked sickening. Ugh, whatever. Just whatever. I'm going to go shopping with Leona Lewis so we can pick out gowns together. Anyway, and she's also in the Lamely. Patrick John Saint Anna said, I love your reactions. Oh, that's so sweet. Please react to I Pray by Mariah Carey. I'm going to give him a heart and a thumbs up, and I'm going to reply. I'm going to say, oh my God, Patrick. For watching and requesting. Okay, I would put a little star there, but I don't have my emoji. But I love you, Patrick. I love you so much, so hard. Because you love Mariah Carey that much to where you ain't even comment about Leona Lewis or about my reaction to Leona Lewis. Oh, yeah, you said I love your reactions. You're so sweet, Dove. Thank you. But then you were like, basically, you put a Mariah Carey request on Leona Lewis's page, and I think that's hilarious. They're like, oh, she gonna see me. She gonna see me. You wanna pay all this attention to Leona Lewis while the queen got Rarity's album done dropped? Listen, you guys, so I got the album, and it is what it is. I actually do not have, I have not heard. Oh, what I wanted to say is, Anytime You Need a Friend by Mariah Carey. I've been requested to react to that song several times, and I did react to it and record it. It was actually requested by Mesmerize for Life Jay. He's also in the Lamely. And so we got a lot of copyright issues on that. So my team over here, we're just trying to work it out to be able to do a proper reaction for you and one that's worthy for the queen, because I don't like chopping and editing to give a reaction. I want to give a whole full reaction to this pure, beautiful song. So look out for Anytime You Need a Friend reaction. We'll see what comes up, y'all, because it's just, it's been a number. I don't know if it's got something to do with Tommy Mottola or whatever, but the copyrights are serious. Anyway, let's get to a serious reaction. How about that? So the song I Pray, I had to look up the lyrics because you know I'm a lyrical girl. The video lyrics that I have, I'm reacting to, is Mariah Carey I Pray lyric video by a YouTube channel called Madame Diosa. So if you want to watch the original video that I'm reacting to and check out her lyrics, her name is Madame Diosa on YouTube. But I'm going to genius.com to I wanted to know about the track a little bit more. I don't just want to, you know what the diva's singing about. I want to know a little bit around the track. That's just how I work. I want to know what spirit and what mind the diva was in when she was, I assume, writing this song. I assume she wrote this. So we're going to read on genius.com. It says, I Pray is track 10 on the Rarities. Mariah wrote this song back in 2005. Oh, for Hawaiian singer Lena Robbins Tamu, who was only 12 at the time. Carey's version was a demo she recorded for Robbins before Robbins premiered her version with a performance on the Oprah Winfrey Show. Shut up. She got to perform a song Mariah Carey wrote for her. And was on the, now let me tell y'all, she was on the Oprah Winfrey Show, which is humongous, you guys. We all know that. But we all know Hawaiians can sing. I didn't say sing. I said Hawaiians can sing. Them islander folks can sing. If you're from an island, you can sing. I don't care if it's cold or hot. You know how to sing. Them island folks be singing in the winds, especially in Hawaii. You got to say it right, Hawaii. Oh man, they could sing Aloha. I love Hawaiian singing. It reminds me just, I'm trying to contain myself right now, but sorry, just, they sound good. Let's just say that. So, okay, that's pretty cool. It also says within the booklet of the rarities, there's a short blurb on each song. The passage on I Pray reads, I wrote this song for a beautiful young singer. Writing for a talented 12-year-old child was unique and freeing experience because it was a way to channel a pure feeling of hope and optimism. Love you, Lena. Oh my gosh. This girl gets mentioned in Mariah's rarities. That's who that is? That's cute. I want to look up who Lena is. Okay, you guys. So now I have to do a reaction to Lena on the Oprah Winfrey Show singing the same song. And we know Hawaiian can sing, so I'm sure she's going to kill it. All right, right now we're going to go back to Madame Diosa's page and check out the lyric video to I Pray. Okay, let me stop there. So I was assuming it was going to be a slow song because it's called I Pray. But I just want to say something. Lambs, I have been going through some situations. And I tell you what, I'm going to leave it to my other YouTube channel so I could explode on there. That's my word vomit. I don't know why Mean Girls is on my mind. But just to, you know, that's more of an emotional page for me. But I need some Mariah Carey. I needed Fly Like a Bird. I was just putting so much toxicity into my mind that I said, I need Mariah Carey's Fly Like a Bird. I need to hear the diva. And all day yesterday, I was just listening to Mariah just bring something else to my spirit. Because I, you know, sometimes we could really be bad and hard on ourselves. But we must remember to bless ourselves with the water, with the word, okay, to calm all that and wash all that. So anyway, I say that to say I'm very excited for this reaction. If you watch it all the way through with me, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And let's get started. Again. Ooh. Hey. Vocals. Come on, Mimi. Child, we waiting on heaven for that child. Let's pray. Yes, he will in the end. Can we just have a moment? Okay. Keep them safe. Okay. I love this song. I love this song. I need my daughter to learn this song. Because she needs to sing it as a solo. This is beautiful. Because my daughter can't listen to all of Mimi's songs. You know what I mean? But this right here, this is beautiful. Pure. Pure. Just like Mimi was saying. It's pure. One day, we get wisdom to the ones who lead us. Jesus, help them find their way. Amen. Girl, you better sing. Listen, Lord, I'm praying. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Lord, I pray. They sang this on Oprah. rock with me, Lamely. I'm jealous. I want to sing this song every day of my life. Dream. Amen. Oh, Kenneth Crouch. Okay. I wonder, is that the Crouch? The Crouch. This is a gospel singer, Andre Crouch. Thank you for watching. Okay, Madam Diosa. So really, it took a whole lot for me not to sing along with this and interrupt it too much. So the reaction is over. I thought that was a beautiful song. I just really wanted to play it again so I could talk more over it because I'm connecting with this a lot. First of all, it says, Lord, I pray. Period, point blank, the first line, Lord, I pray. We need to make sure that we're doing that more. Like, number one, if I could keep it real funky with you, real, real funky. Number one, God really does miss us when we don't talk to him straight up. Everybody else could leave the room. I'm talking to those who have a concern for the world and have a concern or a relationship with God or a belief, just a little sparkle of belief in him. I'm talking to you. We need to make sure that we're not forgetting him, because he's moody. I'm gonna just keep it real. I'll share more about that one day on my other channel, but the Most High is very moody. So he loves if in the morning you just say hello. Oh my gosh, you made that tree, that's hot. Can we just have Paris back for 1 second to say that I love her? That's hot. Anyway, so I love that lyric, Lord, I pray that in my lifetime. Wow, when in my lifetime, she's asking, in my lifetime, and that's dope because it was for a young girl as well, when the world will wake up with unclouded eyes, okay, that's a prayer request, no more need to cry, that's what I was going to say about no more need to cry, that's a heaven situation, we should know that by now in the Bible, it says where there'll be no more weeping or no more sadness, that's in the new heaven and the new earth, because according to the scriptures, God's going to destroy all this. He has to, because look at all this suffering and stuff we got to deal with and stuff like that. So he gives us our time to get it right and everything like that, get ourselves together, grow daily. You know, it hurts, but we got to grow. And those who believe in him and in what he does have for us, those are the ones he says, I could work with you. Come over into heaven with me, because I'm burning the rest of this junk down to the ground, okay? He already flooded it. If you know the story of Noah, come back to me to Sunday school. If you already know the story, some people were trifling. It says in the pages all the stuff they were doing. And hey, he's God. He's the one who can make all these judgments, okay? He can say, I don't like it. It's his world. Now, when you become God, which will never happen, you're not God. When you are God and you make your own world, then sure, you can make the rules that you want to. But the Most High says, you know, I like y'all to be nice to each other and love one another. Please, can you do that? Can you just wash your hands before you eat? Can you do that? These are literally in the Bible, these things to do. Love your neighbor, wash your hands. I'm serious. Y'all be ignoring the first half of the Bible a lot. A lot of people like to read up on Jesus, but they need to remember what God told Moses to tell the people. And there were a lot of laws and rules, X, Y, and Z. But people don't want to do that. So he flooded the earth. He said, well, bye to the lot of you. Bye. I'm God. I'm shutting it down now. Y'all getting out of control. Y'all know how out of control we could be? Don't look so surprised. You know how out of control we could be? So he can't take too much of that stuff. He's allergic to it. He doesn't like wickedness. These are in the pages of the Bible anywhere. He don't approve of it. So he says, well, I will never flood the earth again. And I think the next judgment on earth will be fire. Lord, I'm glad he only doing this, what, one time? Or, you know, first it was water, then it's going to be fire. We don't need air. What is it? Earth, fire, air, water, earth, fire. What's your child? Let's just say God's got a lot of different options on how to take us out. But anyway, the whole point is he plans on cleansing this all and creating anew for those who have sanity, those who don't want to do so much wickedness and robbing and killing. Okay? There's a place where we don't have to cry. As of now, we crying on this rock. We crying on earth. It's too much I can't say right now because, you know, we try and be a holy channel, but it's a lot of carrying on going on around here. And Mariah's tired. I'm tired. God's tired, but he's patient. He's patiently waiting up there for you to call his name, because he only coming for those who he know. I'm like, you ain't even prayed to me one time. Bye. I don't know you. I'm destroying all this. You with me or not? So make sure right now that you are praying with God and everything. But I just want to say, it's good to pray for no more tears and everything. But my point is, that's only for heaven. Here we're meant to grow. Here we're meant to struggle a bit. But God is with you here. Okay? For those of you who accept him, like myself. And I tell you what, I go through a lot. I just lost my child at the beginning of October. It's November now. And I'm real, real bummed out about that. And I'm not going to go into that. But I was caring. I was 3 months. And I was so excited. But the peace that I have from that, knowing, you know, a lot. I'm not going to, again, y'all got to go to my other channel. But anyway, my point is that suffering is here, but I get to have peace because I have the Most High. I can see my child later. Do you understand what I'm saying? Okay. All right. Anyway, let's move on with the lyrics. Keep. Yes. Okay. Wow. Yes. This here. Deliver us from bigotry and hate. Please shelter the wayward children. Okay. We're going to start with deliver us from bigotry and hate. It's always going to be around on this rock. It will always be around because there's always wicked and evil people around. Unfortunately. Unfortunately. But when you got that peace, though, that the Most High gives, Jesus, after they kill him, what happened? After 3 days, he said, I'm going to get on up. Okay? I don't want to stay down here. Dead. I'm the Messiah. I got things to do, and I don't want to do it here. In this cave, the Messiah got on up. He did this, he did that, you know, if you know the Bible. But before he left, he decided to make a big speech. Gather around, everyone. You know, that's all Jesus did was bring crowds to him. And he said, yo, his last speech was, peace I give you, not peace as the world gives. Let your heart not be troubled. I'm going to go prepare a place. And he's talking about heaven. I'm going to go prepare a place for me and you. And then, you know, he ascended on up and peace. I always say Jesus was the first one to say peace out. Like, he ascended, was like, bye, y'all. You know, peace out. But he leaves us peace. He says, peace I give to you. Meaning, whatever bigotry and hate does going on in this world, there's a whole nother place our mind can be mentally. When we're dealing with this type of drama, our mind can be on the peace that the Most High gives to us, which is the future, which is like, heaven, new heaven, and new earth. Meaning, I might be dealing with somebody hating on me now, but I will have peace soon. And there's a lot of people that don't believe in heaven beyond death. And that's cool. Believe it whatever you want. But I choose to believe it. Because if there's so much wickedness, then there's got to be some good there too. And if you read the Bible, you'll understand so much. Or if you stick with me, I'll try and help you out a bit. Y'all, my nails is just a Lord, I pray away, okay? That's really what's going on. So, deliver us from bigotry and hate. I think it's still a good prayer to pray. But just know that it's always going to be around. but it's still good to pray that your family be protected from it. But unfortunately, it's just something that's around. It's always going to be a hater. But that should make you stronger. Step on God's word, to step on whatever you have inside you, to move on from that. It's always going to be someone around here hating. Okay. Next verse. Please give shelter to the wayward children. That, I believe, is up to you and me. When there's kids in trouble or there's foster children, I think it's definitely up to us to pray for them. I think it's definitely up to us to love them. I think it's definitely up to us to give to them. I think it's definitely up to us to love them and see how they're doing and check in on children. I believe that 100%. I believe it because it says it in the Bible. God says, you pay attention to the widows, the hungry, and you pay attention to the orphans. Okay, that's how it was translated back in the day. Now they call them foster children. God understands that there's a kingdom of all these royal people, or this place where all these rich people are, and only rich people could go there because he knows they're hustlers and all this and all that. And he knows they're not going to pay attention to the little guys over here. They're not going to really help out the little people. That's why the Most High says, you do it. Okay, so this is a good prayer to pray. Lord, I pray to help more children every day. Oh my gosh, don't look at my face when I'm praying my secret prayers. Oh my gosh, I got an ugly face when I'm crying. Okay. Keep them safe, amen. Lord, I pray for the world with nowhere. Okay. Once again, this is like the bigotry and hate. It's just here, Mariah. It's just here, Lamely. There's the only world without weapons is the one that God has for you. So if you want this deep in your heart, you're like an activist, it will always be here. The only time there will be peace on this earth, it will be a false peace from the Antichrist. Once again, he says in the pages of the Bible. Listen here now. I'm sorry if you don't want to hear this. You could have been clicked off. The reaction is over. I'm just reacting to these lyrics. These are for the people who want to stick around and break it down like it really, really is going on. Let's not act like this woman ain't praying from her soul for help for you. She's praying for us. She's praying for the world. She's sick of it too. This is why I like Mariah. She understands what's going on, but she needs to remember that the Most High got this all. He know they trying to blow up this and shoot up that. He know. You better keep up underneath that peace that Jesus left to you, though, to be like, whatever. Because they can bust in my house right now. It's whatever, okay? I don't fight with guns and things like that. I got a few. But I'm going to call on Jesus before I even need to use it, before I even need to reach for it. You might have the Holy Ghost come slap you in the face before I even have to go get a weapon. Because the Bible says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness and principalities in high places. That's what we pray for. Pray to bring them down. That's how we fight. Because if you try and stop one person, well, there's going to be another person right there in the way. But if you pray for that spirit to come down and come out, oh, it'll go down to the pits of hell and be locked up there until judgment. So you better pray. That's what I'm trying to say. You can't go around busting caps in people and things like that and expect things to change. It just causes more drama. That demon or spirit will just go on to some other spirit. You pray for that spirit in that person to be taken away to the pit of hell right away in the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay. All right. And amen. All right. For a world with weapons, no weapons on it. Not going to happen. Amen. This is very important to pray. In the Bible, God does say to pray for your leader. So good. Amen. Help them, Lord. Oh, I don't know the words. Amen. Amen. We can live as one. You can live as one right here on earth with just how us Lamely like live here together. Just We gotta, hey, lambs, we gotta stick together, this and that. We have our own community. That's the same thing you have with a spiritual family. Make sure that you do have one, someone who you can call on or talk to for prayer, this, that, and the other. Drop prayer requests, please, in my in the comments below. I have no problem praying for you all off camera for anything that you might need. Word up. Yeah, okay. But yeah, okay, we can move on. You gotta have faith, believe. Wow, Mimi. Lord, I pray. Sorry, the volume. I don't know where we are. Lord, I pray in my life that there will come a day when the world will be open and I don't know what to cry. Yeah, it's for heaven. It's for heaven only. That's it. All right. So that's pretty much what I wanted to say. I love the song. I love the prayer. We should continue to pray. Mariah, of course, sounds beautiful. And I think this is a perfect song for Rarity. And the song is starting to sound a little bit familiar when they go, Lord, I pray. But it could be just because I just heard it. But either way, I love the song. I'm going to be playing it constantly. Let me restart. I'm going to be replaying it constantly for my daughter to learn. I love to hear the sound of my daughter sing. That's my only baby, and I love her so. But you guys, Lamely, stay encouraged, stay lifted up. I love you very, very much. And keep requesting these Mariah Carey. I love her, and I love listening to new songs by her. I don't know all her music, so I'm excited. And look out for the Anytime You Need a Friend reaction, okay? Anything I can do for you, please let me know in the comments, and I pray that I can do them for you. In Jesus' name, amen. And I don't mean to be harsh with anyone, but I like to keep it real on this channel. If the diva's singing about prayer, I need to get into them lyrics and see what she's praying about. And these are good things to pray for. Pray for yourself as well. Pray for yourself. Pray for leaders. Pray for orphans, widows, these people who are in situations that they cannot help. Orphans, widows, and what was it? Oh, and the hungry. Those are the people that you need to pray for sure. And yourself. Okay? All right, you guys. I love you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. They'll find their way. I know there'll come a day I'll move away. Yo, I gotta hear a Hawaiian sing this. I'm not joking, cause I can sing. Let me go on to Hawaii.com real quick. Bye, y'all. I don't got it. Never mind.